Hi, my name is Dr. Brian Curtis. I'm one of the paleontologists here at Fossil Crates. This gorgeous animal behind me needs no introduction, but I'm going to do it anyway. It's Tyrannosaurus Rex, the tyrant king lizard. And this unbelievably gigantic apex predator was arguably the most powerful land predator that ever existed. There's so much that can be said about Tyrannosaurus that a short video won't do its justice. However, I'm going to touch upon some of my favorite parts of Tyrannosaurus. One of my favorites is the fact that its skull has the most powerful bite of any land animal that's ever been discovered. Absolutely enormous power in those gigantic jaws. And one of the evidences for its power, outside of jaw mechanics, is fully enclosed specimen, is its root. This is a dentary tooth. This tooth goes at the bottom of the jaw. And this root here is deep and huge and goes deep into the jaw itself. And it helped disperse the forces from its titanic bite. The shape of the tooth itself is not a pure blade. We joke it's a killer banana. And that shape is very important engineering-wise because it helps dissipate structural forces. Tyrannosaurus rex could literally bite through bone. The element itself, this tooth, has two rows of serrations, and these serrations would make sure that on the off chance its bite didn't kill you, when it removed its bite, when it chomped down and swallowed, it left bloody messes of a wound. So Tyrannosaurus rex had one bite knockout power. It had multiple kinds of teeth in its mouth. That's extremely rare in the meat-eating dinosaur lands. Here is a top tooth. This is a shed maxilla tooth. We know it's shed because it's light brown where the root goes. That's it. This tooth fell out of the animal's mouth, likely while it was chewing on something. Gigantic, and these are not the largest of the teeth by far, but this is a very solid tooth at over 5 inches long. You can see here a hint of the serrations along there and there. Let's see if I can get them both in one shot here. I'll try to put some images up on the screen and show that off. Tyrannosaurus' teeth came together and pretty much bit through whatever it wanted. We found Triceratops with a bitten and healed, partially healed, wound on its hip. Smelled bad. It's very awful. Check our YouTube archives. You'll find Jacob Jett and myself talking a little more details about that particular animal along with some images of it. Tyrannosaurus lived at a time where its prey were armored, a la ankylosaurs, and heavily armed and somewhat armored. The ceratopsians with giant nose and eyebrow spikes or horns, as well as huge frills on the back to protect the otherwise weak neck. Tyrannosaurus had a third kind of tooth in its mouth, the premaxilla tooth here. This is, again, a deep root. That light gray is the root. The black is the actual tooth tip. Now, this was just coming in, so this isn't. This is a premaxilla tooth. It's right up front. And again, this deep, long root is designed to help distribute stress. These also, some have hypothesized, had some ability to be more delicate. They could pick up things. So I always envision like a kitten or a crocodile will pick up its young. I can envision a T-Rex mom or dad gently reaching down with those front premaxillary teeth and just oh so gently moving it. Now, T-Rex's length is over 40 feet long. I believe the longest is right around 43 feet. And its weight is, depending on who you ask, weight's a tougher thing to gauge, somewhere in 8 to 9.5, possibly even 10 tons. It is the heaviest known meat-eating dinosaur. There's been some speculation that Spinosaurus could have been heavier, but because it was over 50 feet long. But for the most part, the Fossil Crates team believes Tyrannosaurus was the heaviest predator until we find fossils that show us otherwise. T-Rex, some of you may have heard that it may have been a scavenger instead of a predator, and that's because in its nose it has these things called nasal turbinates, which are these curly Q, crazy delicate bones in the big nose area. And animals that have that today are like turkey vultures have it, and the turkey vultures use it to sniff the smell of death in the air and then glide over to where it's at, following the molecules back, kind of like sharks follow blood in the water. The thought process is, why would nature have evolved such an amazingly exquisite scent detector? I don't know, but I can tell you that Tyrannosaurus did what it wanted. It wasn't purely scavenger, and it wasn't purely a meat eater. I can envision a T-Rex wandering along and finding an animal that a smaller predator, let's say something a little tiny like a troodon, has taken down and decides it wants to eat that animal's prey. nothing is going to stand up to a T-Rex except another T-Rex. In fact, if you get the chance to visit the Museum of Ancient Life in Lehi, Utah, they have dueling Tyrannosaurus Rexes. They have taken two casts of the stand Tyrannosaurus, which last night was auctioned. We watched it auction, $27.5 million before bidders' fees. I had the pleasure of being at the Sioux auction in 1997, and that was incredible. And she sold for $8 million, and this went triple that amount. And the auction was compelling. Watching it online was very different. Arizona was locked down in quarantine. We couldn't go into New York City, so I wasn't able to attend the auction myself, but I did get to watch it online with thousands of other people. Really neat watching, high drama in theater. I can't wait to see who actually won, and I want to know who placed second. But it's a complete digression on our Tyrannosaurus conversation here. Tyrannosaurus Rex, unbelievably powerful hind legs. That tail behind me was very long and muscular and acted as a counterbalance to the Tyrannosaurus's giant head, and Tyrannosaurus could run very fast, and that tail made him quite maneuverable. Another interesting piece about Tyrannosaurus, and the butt of many, many jokes, is his hand claw. Yep, that's it. Hand claw, 2.5 inches long, had two on each hand. And it would have had a nail around it, but it couldn't reach anything. It couldn't reach its mouth. It couldn't scratch its belly. It had limited mobility, but its arms were about my size, so very strong, muscular arms. Why they were used for, no one knows. My favorite hypothesis is one that, as it is laying on the ground, squatting down, maybe it used and that they'll push itself off. But the reality is Tyrannosaurus didn't need its hands to destroy prey. Its bite could easily chop most things in two pieces and swallow hundreds of pounds of flesh in one gulp. So what you're looking at behind me is Tyrannosaurus Rex, the world's most lethal land predator, in my opinion, and many others. Fossil Crate sells teeth and claws, as well as a scaled skull of the famous Tuft Love specimen. And Tuft's Love specimen is the most complete and best preserved Tyrannosaurus skull ever discovered. So if you're looking to own the best quality Tyrannosaurus Rex skull and put it on your desk, you can't go wrong with the Tuft's Love skull. It's absolutely beautiful. And it comes with some artwork that shows you what bones you're actually looking at on the skull in case you want to learn some cranial anatomy. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please like, subscribe, leave any comments below. Thank you kindly. Adios.